Okay, I have socks, I have a toothbrush, I have sweaters. Oh, hello, B here. I was just packing my bag for a trip coming up. I'll be heading to the mountains in Colorado to ski. I'm running into a problem though. I don't have any snow pants in my closet. Why is that? Well, I live in a climate that doesn't typically experience snow, so I've never had to wear them before. In our last lesson, we learned that weather is what's happening right now, but climate describes the average weather patterns in a location over years. You can also think of weather as your daily wardrobe choice. You wouldn't wear a swimsuit in a snowstorm, right? But climate is like your whole closet. I don't have snow pants in my closet because the patterns of weather where I live don't ever include snow. So what determines climate? Why are there different types of climates around the globe? And how do conditions in the atmosphere impact climate? Today, we'll explore all of this and more. Take a minute and look at some different ecosystems. How would you describe the climate patterns in each area? Think about the amount of precipitation, average temperatures, and sunlight in each location. Pause the video here and record your thoughts. You probably noticed that each ecosystem had its own unique climate patterns. Scientists use the Köppen climate classification system to define the five main types of climates found on Earth. As we learn about each climate, fill out the chart in your lesson video notes. Let's start with tropical climates, which are often found near the equator. These locations are warm year-round and get a lot of rain. Think of rainforests like the Amazon. If I lived here, my closet would have short sleeves and rain gear, but not a winter coat or snow boots. Dry climates, or deserts, get very little rain. You may think deserts are always hot, but deserts can have a wide range in temperature. They can be hot, like the Sahara, or cold, like the Gobi. Some deserts are hot during the day and much colder at night. If I lived here, I would need clothes for hot days and cold nights, but no raincoat. Unlike the previous climates, temperate climate zones do not have the same weather patterns year-round. Instead, locations with a temperate climate have distinct seasons. Places like Europe and parts of the United States fall into this category. It's sweater weather in one season, then sandals in the next season. If I lived here, my closet would have a little bit of everything. Like temperate climates, continental climates have seasons. But unlike temperate climates, continental climates have larger temperature differences between summer and winter and are often found inland. Think of places like Russia or Canada. Winter coats and summer shorts. It's a wardrobe challenge. And lastly, we arrive at the poles. Polar climates are extremely cold. When you think polar, you probably think snowy, but polar climates actually have very little precipitation. So why is there snow on the ground? Well, the little snow that does fall never melts. It's just too cold. The Arctic and Antarctica are prime examples. Living here means loving layers, lots of layers. If I lived here, I would definitely have a puffy coat, gloves, hats, scarves, all of the essentials to keep me warm. Each of these five climate types has its own unique combination of temperature, precipitation, humidity, and other climate patterns. But why? What factors are responsible for influencing climate? let's brainstorm. What factors affect climate? Let's look at our three examples from earlier. Why do you think they have different climates? Pause the video here and record your thoughts. Climate is complex. Things like location, topography, atmospheric conditions, and even vegetation all play a role in determining the type of climate an area has. Let's explore some of these factors. Specifically, we'll focus on location and atmospheric conditions, but feel free to research some other factors on your own. Location factors like elevation and latitude play a huge role in long-term weather patterns. Elevation is the height of an object above sea level. In the troposphere, temperature decreases with altitude, so high elevations, like mountain regions, are cooler than surrounding lower areas. This is why mountaintops can have snow, even in the summer. Additionally, latitude determines the amount of direct sunlight a region receives. Latitude is a location's distance north or south from the equator. How do you think this impacts temperature? Pause the video here and record your prediction. Areas near the equator experience warmer temperatures and more consistent sunlight all year, resulting in tropical climates. Polar regions receive less consistent direct sunlight and remain cold. Mid-latitude regions experience distinct seasons, like continental or temperate climates, because Earth's tilt causes different angles of sunlight throughout the year. This variation leads to warmer summers and colder winters. Proximity to water also affects climate by moderating temperatures. But how? Let's use this map of California in the summer to make a prediction. Pause the video and record the patterns you notice. Think of oceans like a thermostat. Water bodies heat up and cool down more slowly than land, absorbing heat when it's hot and releasing it when it's cold. This means temperate coastal areas often experience milder winters and cooler summers compared to continental inland regions. Additionally, bodies of water evaporate, increasing the amount of water vapor in the air in locations that are close to water. Earlier in this unit, we learned about greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. Greenhouse gases like water vapor, methane, carbon dioxide act like a blanket, trapping heat and keeping the troposphere warm enough for life. This is called the greenhouse effect. The greenhouse effect is critical for life on Earth, and the gases in the atmosphere are balanced to maintain the right climate. But human activities can throw off this balance. When the balance is disturbed, it can lead to climate change, something we'll continue to explore in this course. In this lesson, we learned about the five main climate types and the factors that influence climate. Climate is complex, so there are lots of factors that have influence. Humans can impact these factors, especially when we change the balance of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. Increased heat in the atmosphere is changing climate patterns on Earth right now. But how exactly does heat move through the atmosphere? And what role do different forms of heat transfer play in shaping our climate? In our next lesson, we'll explore the fascinating processes of heat transfer in the atmosphere and how it affects weather and climate patterns. Well, I'd better finish packing for my ski trip. Now that I know about climate, I know exactly what weather patterns to expect in the mountains of Colorado this time of year. But I still need some snow pants. Climate is even bigger than knowing how to pack for a trip. By studying climate, you are preparing to understand and address one of the most important topics of our time. Climate affects everyone, and learning about it is the key to finding solutions. You have the power to lead the way to a more sustainable future. So keep learning, and I'll see you next time. Hey!